pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
March 14th, 2013. I'm Gabrielle Kazin.
And I'm Anthony Gonzalez, and it's once again time for your KTV Live The Quest.
Oh my God, it's Pi Day, Anthony.
Gabby, come. It's not that kind of pie.
It's not the pie you eat?
No, it's Einstein's 3.14 pie.
Oh.
That kind of killed your mood, didn't it?
Well, I mean, it's math, so.
Yeah.
Okay, let's get into today's news. According to iBidTimes.com, it is rumored that the Samsung Galaxy S4 is coming out this month. The Samsung Galaxy S4 is a new addition to the most purchased cell phone family next to the iPhone. Samsung has announced a new feature of the Samsung Galaxy S4 are Wi-Fi combo chips. A Wi-Fi combo chip is a wireless network, chips installed in the phone to produce a wireless network or a hotspot. Also, the screen is a lot larger. It went from 4.8 inches to 5.5 inches. According to iBidTimes.com, the Samsung Galaxy S is the number one Android in the world.
The MJHS is having a book drive to collect books. All donations will go to the Bridge of Books Foundation for underprivileged kids. Be sure to bring in your book donations tomorrow. If you have any questions, see Ms. Casale in room 4.
Many people go to Irish restaurants to feast on their favorite Irish food. Because St. Patrick's Day is in a few days, Ryan interviewed a few students asking them what their favorite Irish food is.
That's right, guys. From corned beef and cabbage all the way to soda bread, almost everyone loves to eat Irish foods on St. Patrick's Day. Let's see what some people eat on St. Paddy's Day and learn a little bit about those foods.
My favorite thing to eat on St. Patrick's Day is raisin bread.
Irish raisin bread, also known as bomb brack, is usually served in Ireland with butter and tea in the afternoon.
For St. Patrick's Day, we like to eat Irish soda bread.
Yeah. Soda bread is usually made with cake materials rather than bread and can be made with yogurt as an ingredient.
My favorite food to eat on St. Patrick's Day is cornbread.
Cornbread originated in the late 1850s and was cheap and easy to make.
My favorite Irish meal on St. Patrick's Day is corned beef and cabbage.
Corned beef and cabbage was originally bacon and cabbage but was swapped out by American immigrants because it was cheaper.
According to food.com, the most common Irish food to eat on St. Patrick's Day is soda bread. Corned beef and cabbage is also common at this time.
Today is the famous scientist's birthday, Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein was a physicist who studied theories and mathematics that are now used today. He is best known for his theory of E equals mc squared and established the quantum theory. Albert Einstein died on April 18, 1955 at the age of 76 in Princeton, New Jersey. Einstein's birthday is also known as Pi Day, due to his theory of pi.
So you are here with my daily dose of sports?
Yes, I am. Last night was very interesting. Well, in basketball, the Miami Heat, they became the fourth team in NBA history with 20 wins, and they beat the 76ers 98-94.
Wow, that's really good for them.
It is. And the Lakers ended their four-game winning streak with a 96-92 loss to the Hawks.
Well, it's really bad for the Lakers because they were winning and then they lost.
It is. Well, then the Knicks lost 117-94, and Carmelo and Chandler are both out with knee troubles.
Oh, that's bad.
That's not good.
Okay, see you later.
Bye.
The Clark Education Fund will be hosting the annual wine tasting on April 5th, 2013. It will be hosted at the Grand Centurions from 7:30 to 10:30. Be sure to tell your parents to go. Tickets are $55 per person and $65 at the door.
Today, we have a locker scavenger hunt between three sixth graders who had to find three green items for St. Patrick's Day theme. Let's see who takes the win.
First up, we have Ty Dobbins.
Ty right away finds his first item. It takes Ty a little while to find his second item. Ty finds a green piece of paper.
Ty finished with a total time of 1 minute and 13 seconds. Second, we have Tom Sweeney.
Right away, Tom finds a green piece of paper. He has a little trouble finding his second item, but finds the green water bottle cap. And his last item, he finds another green piece of paper. Tom finished with a total time of 31 seconds. Lastly, we have Emily Macklin. Right away, Emily pulls out all three green items with no trouble. Emily finished with an amazing time of 6 seconds. This means Ty came in third, Tom came in second, and Emily came in first, making her the winner of this locker scavenger hunt.
Congratulations to Emily for making KTV breaking record with 6 seconds in a locker scavenger hunt.
So, we actually had a little bit of a mistake. Einstein had nothing to do with pie.
Yeah.
But still be happy it's Pi Day.
Yeah, Pi Day, math, awesome.
In other news, we have a little break in the show with Natalie and Desiree over there, so let's get into that.
Today we have, it's going to be a pretzel, $1.
No, 2 pretzels for $1, right?
That is right, but I have $5, so how many pretzels can I get?
10 pretzels? I'm good at math, so.
Yeah, I'm just going to feast out.
Oh, wait, you probably eat them
wait,
all.
Where's my money going to?
The NJHS is hosting it for charity, for children's charity.
That's a great idea.
I know.
You guys better go do it for the children.
Do it for the children.
Back to you guys in the studio.
Apparently we need to do it for the children.
Right, that's great. I'm definitely going to buy some chocolate-covered pretzels.
Me too. I love chocolate-covered pretzels. They're so yummy.
Delicious.
I can't wait to buy them.
I love it.
All right, so let's get back to today's news.
Yes.
New Jersey Music and Dance Company announces the third annual auditions for scholarships to the 2013 Summer Theater and Dance Camp held at the NJ Center for Media Arts. The audition dates are March 23rd and March 24th from 1 to 5 p.m.
Today's KTV holiday is International Ask a Question Day. Wikipedia.org said that there are no stupid questions, only stupid answers. The best part of today is that you can ask any of your teachers as many questions as you can today. They don't have to answer them, but you can at least try and ask them questions. Wikipedia also stated that on average, a 4-year-old child asks 437 questions a day.
So, Megan, how is my weather looking?
The weather's looking pretty good, but we still got weather for the next 4 days. Oh. So let me tell you that. Today, it'll be partly cloudy with a high of 39.
Oh, my God, so it's really cold.
It's not too bad, though, as in, you know, rain.
It was like 50 yesterday.
It was. Tomorrow, it'll be mostly cloudy and a high of 48, so it shoots back up again.
Yeah.
To kick off the weekend, there'll be rain and possibly snow with a high of 41.
You know, I don't really like snow because it gets slushy at the end.
But you can have a snowball fight. That's what
fun.
I'm excited for. And finally, on Sunday, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 46.
So it's getting warmer?
Yeah, it's getting warmer for St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah.
And that'll be awesome.
All right, so. See you later, Megan.
All right.
Samsung's next Galaxy smartphone might be controlled by nothing more than the user's eyes. When is the new phone being revealed? Is it A, March 28th? Maybe B, today? How about C, April 26th? Or lastly, D, tomorrow? According to CNET.com, another name for this technology, iScroll, is called the iPause. And the answer is B, today. This iScrolling invention will do things like scroll down a page of text when the user's eyes have reached the bottom of the screen. The phone is going for $149 when it hits stores.
NJHS members are collecting all sorts of items for the Bristol-Myers Squibb Children's Hospital. You can donate items ranging from infant toys to batteries. The donation boxes will be located in the main lobby.
So it's the end of the show.
Yeah, but we have a preview over there. So let's pass it to them.
Tomorrow, it's always Fun Friday.
Yes.
It's always a packed out show. Tomorrow, we have an interview with the lacrosse coach. He's a pretty cool guy. He's both of our coaches, Greg.
Yeah, he's great.
Lacrosse. And then also, we have a music video on how to keep your head in the game, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, I always got my head in the game.
Nice. Back to you guys in the studio.
That's really exciting.
That really is good.
But we have one more thing. Tomorrow there will be an NJHS meeting at 7:15. So you all need to go.
Yeah.
7:50.
For your yearbook
and
picture.
And yearbook pictures.
So make sure to bring your smile.
Yeah. So for even more KTV news, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. For Anthony Gonzalez and the rest of the KTV News team, I'm Gabrielle Kazin. Have a groovy day.